Hey everybody, and welcome to episode 41. Look at this beautiful sight. Not this. This isn't so much a beautiful sight. That's like staring at construction while you're driving through town. No, this is a beautiful sight. This tree. Was this tree here last episode? I can't remember if I did this off camera afterwards or not. But anyways, welcome, welcome, welcome. How are you guys? I am doing well. I am working on some roads because I think it is time. We're getting around to finishing the exterior of the Farmers Guild. And the rest of the town is starting to become a priority, and I've been enjoying Minecraft more lately. I don't want to make it sound like I haven't been, but I've been like just wanting to get on and watch some. I went back and I used to watch Etho all the time, and I haven't kept up with his stuff. I went back like a year and started watching his old Let's Plays and catching up to current time, and I've just like had fun just playing and watching him, which I haven't I haven't done a ton of lately, just grinding on my own time. So I've been enjoying that. So I'm thinking it'd be a good idea to lay out some of the town, which is part of what we're going to do today. Lay out some of the town, maybe lay out where we're going to have some buildings, and then when I have some free time, just go crazy with the with building some houses. Now, I'm putting this road in a very straight line. You probably notice. It's not going to be straight. It's going to be more like this. It winds just a little bit, but, it's going this way for the most part. This is kind of one of our main roads going through the town. It goes this way. It's going to come this way. Maybe wind up this way. I'm not sure. And then this is the road leading to the Farmers Guild, and I do have some work. Ooh, frame rates, hello. I do have some work done inside of the Farmers Guild since last time. Last time we worked on that meeting hall, well, it's almost done. And I've actually started getting into the bulk of floor planning and stuff, so I'm going to save that stuff for later. Let's just mix this up a little bit so it doesn't look quite so straight. We're gonna need a lot of stone. I think I am gonna have this wind this way just a little bit for now. Let's focus on maybe now we take it up this way and knock that out. Just get an idea of where we're going, and then it can come this way. I'm not sure everything that's gonna go in here. A lot of houses, and I might mix in some unique buildings. If we do unique buildings, you'll definitely see them. If I do just boring houses, I'll probably just show them in passing. But yeah, I'm gonna need a lot of stone, and then we're gonna lay this out, and I'll show you what I come up with. This is what I do for the most part when I'm making these roads. The section right here is different from the section over there. I'm using different materials. This section will continue using cobblestone. The four things right here. And I'm just going to go through while we talk about a bit of Minecraft news, which is exciting, especially given that we're becoming used to not having so much Minecraft news, I think. But the thing that is important to us today is that Minecon just happened, and they pretty much showed us, I think, most of, if not all of, what is going to be on update 111. And actually, as of this going up, the snapshot for it is out. I'm not messing with it because snapshots can just be a little difficult to mess with on worlds that you care about. So if you do update to it, back up your world. I have had problems before, but anyways, new stuff mostly I'm not going to go over all of it, but for the most part, it's an adventure update. There's a few things that are cool to me that are kind of quality of life updates, as far as like a backpack type deal, but it's more of a chest that you can carry. A lot of it is survival focused, adventure focused, and I was watching B-Dub's episode just recently, just like 30 minutes ago or something, and he put it a good way. He said that survival type stuff for most of us that have been playing this game for a long time is good for about a week's worth of fun. And then, okay, I find the new mansion that's out there. I do whatever there is to do in it. Well, I don't have to experience that ever again. I go and what else is there? I don't even remember. There's llamas. Oh, I get a llama. Maybe I use it here and there, but okay, whatever. No big deal. I'm not hating on it. I'll go into that too, but it's like, if we got some building blocks, we'd be set forever. We'd be using those forever. So I really hope that Mojang starts putting more focus into building maybe for us in the future. But the updates have been coming pretty often. So no matter what, I'm not picky. Like, I'm not going to complain. I just think that there are... I just don't think that's going to do us any difference. In fact, we're in 1.10, but since I upgraded in 1.10, I don't think I've done anything to do with the update. I don't remember what all was in 1.10, but it hasn't affected us a whole lot because there was bone blocks, but I haven't used them. I don't even have enough bones to really make use of them. So I'm going to place down the rest of these, and then this is mostly what it's going to look like. You can see the hello words. You see most of it right here. Little tip of the day, if you are mixing roads like this, not necessarily if you're mixing stone and dirt roads, but more like two similar roads like this, don't have it so clearly separated. I'm gonna put in one of those blocks there, so it kind of looks like it's encroaching in on that style, and I'm gonna put a brick right there and maybe even up here. And ooh, I almost want to do it like way up here. Yeah, that looks pretty good to me. So right here, it's kind of a mix of both styles. Anyways, we are right next. So a lot of poor people are going to have to be right by the cow pasture. It's going to smell. Look at all these cows that we got in here. They sure don't like this corner very much. I don't know why. Maybe I smell and they don't want to be near me. Anyway, guys, check out or keep your eyes open if you're watching this the day that it goes up. Or maybe even the same day or the day before, look on my channel. There's a new collaborative project coming soon. First collaborative project, and I'm pretty excited for it. It's a building game, mini game type thing, and it's something I've never seen anyone do before. Look how foggy it is here. I turned out my render distance a little bit, and it's very, very foggy, almost a little too foggy. But anyways, I want to go inside. I think we'll do some more over there in just a moment, but I want to go inside and show you everything that I've done in the meantime off camera. So, first thing that you're going to notice, it feels much more enclosed, right? That's because I worked on this in particular, and a little bit of the back wall, which I plan on finishing off so we can get an enclosed room. I think that will be very important on getting the final feel of the room. I don't know what to do with this back wall, but so let's look at what we're doing over here. I wanted to keep it fairly symmetrical, so I brought the roof. Let's take a look at it. The roof went down over here. You can see that right there. I brought it over and had it go up so that the middle of this room was the middle of this pattern. And that's going to work out for us because we're not really going to be able to see over there once this is all said and done. This is probably going to be this section right here. There will be a building or a room, and we won't be able to see in there. This is more like an open, lofted hallway, which we can get up if we are tricky about it. And this will be connecting us to that room and whatever is over here. And this is really cool. I think this is a really cool view right here. And it's one of those things that I talk about where if you're wandering through a building and let's say you go down, there's a stairway down there. Let's say you end up somehow on a second floor and you come here and you end up on this hallway and you look down and you're like, oh my gosh, there's the meeting room. This place is huge. It's all tied together. That's the kind of feeling that I get when I see that kind of stuff. And that's the kind of feeling that I want people to get if they were to walk up there. So that's important to us. Another thing, I kept these pillars symmetrical to these. I don't have the torches in place over here, but there will be torches. Not like that, rather like that. And the reason I have them so high up is because you can't put them behind this chair here, because that door is occupying the same space. What else? There's going to be a hallway over here going who knows where. I put a hallway right here going down into this hallway, which comes over here. So we go up here. Who knows? There's some... not sure this wall space is going to get used for. There's even a basement area here, and this is probably going to end up being a storage room. I already put a couple closets right there, and this is going to be roughly the size of it, this part that I've dug out a little bit. Maybe we can store some hay down here or something. I don't know. That's such a lazy way of doing stuff around here, I feel like, because who the heck brought hay in here through the front, brought it over here through the hall, and placed it down here. That doesn't make much sense to me, I guess. So, gotta think about what we're doing, I suppose. Although this is Minecraft. Does anyone really care? Does anyone put that much thought into it? I'm not really sure. The next thing that I do want to do, however, is lay out a few houses and also show you how I go about filling in some space like this right here. And there's a few other things that I see that are calling my name. Let's do this right now. So first thing that I want to do is finish this pathway right there. Let's put down some stone. So I went to a Mumford and Sons. Don't have any gravel. Do I have coarse dirt? I do. Went to a Mumford and Sons concert. First time I'd seen them, and it was really good. They're really good live. They played... a lot of people I know complain about some of their newer stuff, maybe not having the same style or whatever. They played a lot of their older stuff. What am I looking for? Gravel. With electric guitars, where they normally would have been all acoustic, and it actually rocked. It was awesome. And at one point, the singer, I want to put one of our stone walls here. The singer actually ran up through the crowd, and it was this big amphitheater, right? And I'm like on this grassy area kind of higher up. And he runs through the crowd, basically runs a circle around me. And I'm like, whatever. It's cool, but it's a guy. What am I going to do? I'm not going to, like, go touch him or anything. Well, apparently I'm the only one who thinks like that. I need some walls. And I think that one of these... yeah, there's a crafting bench right there for some reason. Apparently everyone else thought differently than me. Because everyone else ran after him, like, stampeded towards him to touch him. Which is a little weird, guys. I can't imagine that. I don't know. He was like shielding himself. He was singing, or at least there was a singing track while he was doing it. I don't know if he was actually singing because it sounded really good. And I wouldn't be surprised if he took a few hits to the face. the way that people were swarming him. But they plowed through me. Like, they just did not care that there was a guy standing there just to touch this guy. And they're like grown adults. Like, I touched him. Where do we have a bed anywhere? Do we not have a bed in any of these houses? Like, oh, look, there's a cow in our wheelbarrow. I just noticed that. Like, oh, I touched him. I'm like, well, why? Like, it's so weird. Just touch another guy. I don't know. People are weird. But it was cool having him run right by while he was singing, I guess. Anyways, I put down a wall there. You can see that. I'm looking for... I really need leaves because I don't do those walls very often. Without throwing in some proper leaves, I know where they are. They're in here. I've got 3 bone meal on me. Give me lots of grass and not much flowers. Thank you. I really need a skeleton farm. Really bad. Especially if I ever want to use that, the bone blocks, because I want more grass than that. Do I have any bone meal in here? I probably have bones hidden somewhere, because I have spent quite a few nights just looking for skeletons. Let's clean up this inventory real quick. It's such a mess. I make things and then it makes multiple things of the things when I only need a few of them. I mean, it makes 2 trapdoors, so that was clearly my fault making more than I needed, but... I'm looking through this like, what don't I need? Oh, nope, I need everything. No, you don't, you dang guy. Get rid of it. Put it away. Just put away all the stone. Grab it another time. Get the bone meal. So, prettying up the areas for these houses is not that tough. Let's actually grab a few more bushes. Like that. It's really not that tough. I get rid of the flowers because it just looks... It's too much. It's too many flowers at the end of it all. Like, here and there, who cares? But when it's everywhere... Let's even put some too high grass here. This guy does not take care of his lawn very well. That looks awful, guy. You gotta work on that. See, that gave me like one grass and one flower. What the heck? Yeah, like that. So that really didn't take much work. I just do my wall design here. Throw in some very randomly placed fence, like that. And then put down some grass. And that looks a lot better than it did. Let's actually do something similar here. Let's do that. Right. Oh, that's not what I wanted at all. And I end up with a yellow flower there anyway. Yeah, so I don't like this big grass right here on the corner. That's like, it's blocking my view coming around. So that I'm going to get rid of. I almost don't like that being right there, but I'm going to say screw that for now. I don't care too much. I think it's fine. This area could be prettied up. This building has been sitting here unfinished for like 20 episodes. but that didn't take a lot of time. So if you've got a town and you've just got a bunch of houses and you're like, what can I do to pretty up? Grab a bunch of fences, grab a bunch of stone, grab a bunch of leaves, grab a bunch of bone meal. Just go to every house and do it one at a time. Throw down your fences, throw down your walls, throw down your leaves, and then your bone meal, and you'll be amazed. It'll take like 20 minutes, and it'll be a completely different environment. So before we get into... I still have to make little stair step things there, but let's actually grab a couple stacks of cobblestone and map out where there's going to be a few buildings. So I definitely want one on this corner. Let's do a 5 by 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 should leave us plenty of room with that tree. If nothing else, we can build it into the tree a little bit and make the tree touch it with the leaves. That wouldn't be an awful thing. Now, the backside of this, the original plan was this is an elevator for hay and goods, and it gets brought down to the second floor, or the first floor from the second floor. Excuse me, I'm moving in my seat, and I'm positive that you can hear it. Gets brought down here, and then there's going to be maybe some kind of crane here that brings it over there, and then that's where we have our industrial area planned out. So I definitely want a road going right through here. So we don't want a house right there, but I think a house right here will definitely work. Let's do a 7 wide. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And a 5. Yeah. I try to mix it up. Actually, let's really mix it up. Let's make this one a different shape, like that. And is that weird? Is that weird? Feels like a weird shape to me. No, that'll be fine. That'll be fine. I thought I had evens there, but it's just because of how I split it. It ended up looking like it was even. So, what else? What the heck are you for? I'm not entirely sure. That's coarse dirt. I don't want that. There we go. So we've got two houses right there. Those guys are buddies. Something nice about having this one turn this way is, a while ago I was making these and I realized that all the roofs were facing the same way. They were, the thatch side of it was facing east and west. I made this one over here with, sorry, I'm like playing hands off, so that's why sometimes you catch me just looking at weird places, because I'm fidgeting with my hands. But I placed that one there, and it looks so much better coming from that direction, not having them all facing the same way. But we definitely have room. We could put another one here, right? I think I counted that out right there. I'm not too concerned about it right now. For the most part, I'm just marking out an area. There's our pasture, so we're probably not going to go much further than that. However, we can have a road going back here and have another house here, right? Again, I don't know if I'm counting these out right. Not too concerned about it at the moment. I'm pretty sure that that's 8 long. So maybe that can stay 8 long. Who knows? That will be there. And then maybe we have another one here that's kind of got a basement entrance down below, right? So we do like one of these deals right here where we bring this out, and then it'll be sort of an overhang like that. Again, this is just marking, so I'm not too concerned about the numbers. So we can have a door here while we imagine as if the building started here normally. And that's right there. Planned out 5 buildings, and we could plan out more. Let's do, how many do I have facing that way? Let's do another one facing this way, so that we have the thatch facing north and south. We can also sleep, and we went through a lot of cobblestone there. And also sleep. And finish this one off. I don't need you there. Yeah. Right. And then these are at different heights, so that's going to bring a lot of depth to this area. But right there, we added 6 houses that are to be planned for. We can have a path come out this way for something. We could probably put another house right here. I don't know if I want this open or not. I'll think about that. I think I might put a house here of some sort. Maybe a specialized house. I don't know. And then we have room for a good one house here, maybe one there, a couple here, And that's like our town right there. Now, that's easier said than done. That's basically doubling the size of this town. And I do want to do something to border off these mountains from the town. I noticed something. Last episode, I talked about how B-Dubs did an episode on exteriors, doing a lot of custom trees and stuff like that. And something I noticed that he did that he didn't even talk about was he did tree lines like that. Like, he would do them right here on the hillside, on the top of the hill. So like you just see the trees, and you don't see that there's a different biome over there or something like that. And that could really stop you from thinking about the fact that maybe it would have been better placed if this was a bigger plains biome in the middle of a plains biome for a farming town. But that should kind of set a boundary for the town as well. And then we have a whole little area right there that would be cool to do something with. I could probably do a water mill house right here. And that's actually, those are fun. I bet we could do one of those really easy. But anyways, that's a lot of the thinking that goes through my head when I'm thinking about the layout of a town. I'm thinking about where my main road goes, what you have to consider around it, like a road going right here, leaving room for the pasture right there, and maybe a pathway behind the pasture, or right here in front of the pasture. Elevations. This is all stuff that I think about when making my buildings, placing them. I don't put them in a grid, unless you're doing like a proper city style modern build, then putting them in a grid is just going to be a no-no. Just don't even try it. But that is my thought process. That's what I like to talk about, kind of get my building done off camera and then talk about what I was thinking about. Let's go ahead and close in, or try to get this closed in, so we can get a good view of this, for the most part, finished room. And I don't know what I'm going to do on this wall here. I've thought, you know, like the head of a moose, you can make them pretty easy with gates and stuff for antlers I've seen. I don't want a fireplace in here, certainly not one that's lit. Well, I'm not even messing with it. Just don't even think about it. This is going to be ceiling. So let's... I'm not sure if that... I think that closed off that gap. So that's going to be ceiling. This actually doesn't even need to be there. Do we have any of these? We do. So let's go ahead and completely close it in and get a good idea of what we're looking at. Right there. Nope, this can actually go away. This can actually go away as well. See, a lot of this stuff that makes a big difference is just grindy stuff, like this roof. I just had to go collect a ton of wood, and then I just had to place it. And it's like one of those things that's, I'm like, I don't want to do it. But really, it doesn't take that long, and it makes such a big difference. I can spend 2 hours working on a stupid little room, but in the end of it, working on this roof or something makes a big difference. So this pattern is going to need to brought all the way back, that's for sure. This, everything right here is going to have to be cleaned up in some way or another. I don't know how. And this is the room that we've got. This did not get finished up, and as I want to place that there. Oh, darn it. Yeah. Is it really not going to let me? Okay. I see how it is. Right there, right? Nope, I screwed it up. I had one job. Right there. So now let's look at, this is, for the most part, a finished hall. Now, just looking at it like this, I've got ideas running through my mind. Finishing this did give me ideas, which is kind of cool. The first thing that comes to mind is using clay. And yeah, dark gray clay and yellow clay, those colors, to do some sort of symbol or crest up there on that wall. I just realized I'm fidgeting so much. I'm so sorry if you can hear that. I have a squeaky chair, kind of. It's material that squeaks when you move on it, like. But anyways, I don't think I want to bring stone back there. I think I want to put a pillar right here in the corner. Let's do that because it's on that one side, but not on this side. Do I have any stone in here? No, I do not. I do not. That's just interior stuff for the most part. And the stone is not interior stuff. Well, it is right now. Look how much busier it looks just putting down those platforms. And now that I've got those platforms down, I can just, like, I think I'll just do them, like, one at a time, like, do the base. All of our houses have a cobblestone base. Just do the cobblestone base on all of them. Do the wood top. Do the trim for the ceiling. Do the roof. And then, bam, you've got your basic house without some of the details. Hello, frame rates. Goodbye, frame rates. So let's put this down right here, and I almost feel like, is this not even? Oh my gosh, it's even, right? It's even. It's just that these are set back one. What is going on here? This is our center block, and that is, and the top part of the ceiling is definitely 5 wide. No, that's even. Yeah? Why is this block half a block higher? Oh, I see what I did. That block is actually stone over there. Okay, so that makes more sense. Let's also do that. Right? We could maybe even put another window there. That would look a little awkward, I think. Actually, this looks awkward, having the stone here. I don't like that. So let's at least do that. Yeah, that looks better. So I think a crest will go right there. And then we probably don't need much more. Maybe some sort of lighting, like torch fixtures could go a long ways. Normally, they're not that big of a detail, but I think if we had some sort of a crest right here and then did this style fixture like right there and right there, I think that would really pull your eye to the center of the room, really frame this chair here. I'm kind of thinking to myself, figuring this out on my own. This kind of bothers me, that right there. I feel like that should be oak. We're going to notice that more in here than we're going to notice there being an oak slab up on the roof. Oh yeah, I also did some work here. You can actually walk up here now. So this is the pathway. I added these railings. I think these are brand new to you guys. And then there's stairs right here. Leads down here. Which leads out here. So everything is coming together very well. There's some stuff for me to think about off camera, work on off camera. So thank you for watching, everybody. Next time, look forward to seeing what we got, and look forward, keep your eyes out for that collaborative minigame. It's really going to be showing off some building skills, so check in with that. And this, I just realized that this kind of bothers me, that I don't have any 1.5 block tall parts for this wall. I got to finish it before this episode's done. Let's put that right there. We'll just use one of these slabs right there. Look at that. Much better. So the sun is going down. The windmill is barely in sight. Thank you for watching, everybody. Hey. Bye. Bye.